What is up everyone, how are you doing? Welcome back to Geometry Dash. This time I'm getting the intro on one cut, I'm doing it this time. So you may be wondering, what are we doing today? Well today we're going to be doing another Building with Lemons episode, because I know how much you guys like them. So we're going to be building a 1.9 level today, and the reason for that is because I like to build old nostalgic stuff, and this seemed like a cool style to do. So the 1.0 video did pretty well, people seemed to like that, apart from the fact that it wasn't too strict on the 1.0 with the custom song, and maybe forgot a few objects. But this time I've done my research, I know it's in 1.9, it's when I started getting into creating really, and I think it should be fun. You know, 1.9 was a golden age, I missed that time, and we're going to jump right back into it. So, as per usual, I've made us a layout right here, with this cool song, Lucky Coin by Stiffles or whatever. So here it is, it's kind of cool actually, we've used a lot of slopes and, you know, it's all 1.9. I don't think you can find any big major faults here. So basically, we're gonna decorate it. I mean, what the hell else are we gonna do? It's a goddamn Building with Lemons episode. We'll start out with colors actually. You know what, let's start out with colors. We'll enable the ground so we can see that. We'll choose us a cool 1.9 background. How about these kind of bricks and, we'll go with, you know, we'll go with the Theory of Everything 2 background. It's pretty cool. What color should we go with today? I'm thinking kind of like a very intense pink, you know, like almost scarlet, just kind of pink. You know, let's go with that. Sure. So we want to make the background a little darker because a bright background really looks good. So we'll have it there and we'll make the ground even darker. There we go. Look at that. We've got our background colors and our ground colors. Now that's all we're going to do for now because we haven't actually placed any decoration. So I think we're actually going to go with 3D blocks here today. I've been avoiding 3D blocks recently because, I don't know, I've just been trying to take a little break from them, but we're going to be doing them here because, you know, 3D blocks were introduced in 1.9 and, you know, they seem quite fitting. So I'll probably cut that out and I'll see you in about a second. Okay, so we've made the 3D blocks at last. And there's a few things you can note. Oh, wait a second. God, look at the bugger, get in there. Come on. Okay, so now we've actually made the 3D blocks. There's a few things to note. Oh my God. So there's a few things to note here. One is that I've actually done this. A lot of people leave this out when they put 3D lines in. But you can actually add 3D lines to the reverse facing slopes. And if you do them carefully, you can do them like that. Done it over here too. So that was done. And I've also moved these objects up a bit so they're in the middle of the 3D blocks. This is a common practice for most of my levels, but I don't see a lot of people using it, so that's one thing you can note, I suppose, in this video. While we're here, this block kind of caught my eye, so we're just going to place it around a bit. I think this stuff is quite cool, and I'm pretty sure it was 1.9. I think it was actually 1.8 it was introduced. Now is the fun part. We're going to get onto block design, and basically, I'm not too sure what I'm going to be doing. Okay, so looking back through here, I did see a block that caught my eye. Here it is, this kind of brick block. These were very common back in 1.9, and I think they're cool. We're going to give it a new color and we're just going to make it the background color but brighter and blending. So like that, that could be cool. And we'll place them around on simply the top parts. So like so, we'll place them on the top and the bottom will be a different design. So now we need to get this part here and give it this design here. Whoops. And there we go, we've placed the top part there. We might also do this to separate it from the bottom as well. That could be a cool idea. So now we've done a little bit of the block design. As you can see, we want to add some more stuff to the bottom, of course, and we're going to need to find another cool block. And these ones look quite tasty, so we'll place some of them. And why don't we make this one green? Hell yeah, that looks pretty good. So we're going to make these ones green on the bottom, and on the top is going to be pink. And we're just going to place some more of that around there. Got to be careful because we're not going to overlap with anything. That would not be nice. And now for the corner parts, and we're almost done with this part of the design. So we're almost done with the block design, but you may be asking, what are we going to place in these empty, horrible spaces? Now the answer to that is simply these blocks. They're the same color as the outline of these, so they'll blend in quite nicely. And we can place them around, and we've also got matching blocks for the corner pieces. If we can find them, that is. And the last one, I mean the second last one, and the last one, and we're done. That's block design for you. We're actually just going to lower our 3D line opacity a little bit. I mean, lower the brightness. As you can see, that looks a little better. Oh, we've got these ones. So there you have it. There's the block design done. 1.9 block design in the bag. Now, what we're going to be doing over here is something slightly inspired by blast processing. So this is something that I don't really see creators doing. Like even in 1.9, this was not popular, but I think it looks pretty cool. So we're going to make some kind of cool structure with these two blocks here. So it goes dark, light, and then goes like this. And then we can get these outline blocks here and just build it up a little bit and then surround it with these. I mean, that looks pretty good, right, doesn't it? And what we'll do here with these pillars is we'll place one of these things. So these are the player colors and they kind of have a purpose now, don't they? Pretty nice. So I think we'll do the pulses now. And of course we can't use these, just like the 1.0 video, we've got to use color triggers and we'll make ourselves a little pogs. So you want the background to go back to what it was and pulse slightly like this. So that should be good. Now we want to do the ground too. So we'll simply grab the ground color, do what we did here, except make this slightly darker, and we shall make this G1. That's pretty cool. And we're also going to be sneaky and do an object pulse, because, you know, object pulses are pretty cool. We'll go blue, a blue flash, and then it returns to white. How about that? So there you go, we've got our pulses, we can copy paste them around. Another little thing I thought I could do here is to add some shading to these blocks, and we might just make, we'll add a new color. Of course, we only had four colors in 1.9. I did forget to say that before, you've got color 1 to 4, and we've got to be careful what we use. So 2 will be assigned the black one. So we can use that to shade these blocks a little bit and make them look a little better. And hopefully it should look cool. So there you go, we did some simple shading and it already looks a lot better. Like, that looks pretty tasty actually, if I do say so myself. So now for some orb design. What shall we do for the orb design? I don't know, let's just decorate this beautiful orb. So we have these things here, which I think could look cool. We'll place that down there like that. And another thing I might use here is this, and we're gonna go light background. So light background was a thing that is not really used anymore. It's kind of obsolete, but it's pretty cool. It flashes with the background. So that's cool, and when the background goes darker, and say if I was to do this, grab the background color and make it go black, it would turn to the player color. As you can see, it's turning to the pink on my icons. So it's a pretty cool feature, and it's kind of obsolete now, which is quite sad, because it's still a cool little thing. So we've almost finished our orb design. We're gonna grab some of these, and we'll just make them the player color too. So yellow for me, and whatever you want for you. And to finish off, we're gonna grab a little bit of shading. So, back then, you couldn't use things like this. You had to do this. You had to do it the old-fashioned way. Back in my day, we used to make orb glows like this. Oh. So you do that, and then we're gonna make it black. And we're gonna cheat a bit and use a bit of layering, because I know layering wasn't in 1.9, but honestly, it's all good. Don't worry about it. There you go. Sweet. Now we just paste it around a bit. And we're all good. So what have we done so far? We've done a random decoration over there, we've done block design, we've done orb design and colors. Still quite a bit more to do. So we're gonna make ourselves a trusty old arrow, because you can't go wrong with an arrow. We're gonna stick with light background again, and we're gonna use this and this. So this one will be, I think we'll make this green, and this one can be pink, and we'll put them inside here. Cool, that looks pretty nice. Now we're gonna get a hexagon, and we're gonna give our last color, we're gonna assign our last precious color, and basically we're gonna make a really opaque kind of pink. Now the way we did this back in 1.9, we didn't have this opacity slider here. This is a luxury, dude. Like, you had to go blending and make the color really dark, so basically that will make it opaque. And there you have it, we've made our arrow, but we're also going to turn it into our own varied version, which is going to be, goddamn delete you bastard, come on. Which is gonna, sorry about that, it's gonna be an exclamation mark to signal danger, because, you know, I like my exclamation marks. So the first arrow will go there, and here we're gonna put our exclamation mark, just because why not? One more arrow here. So we're also gonna make these little arrows here. We're just gonna keep it simple for this one. We're just gonna have simply that, and we'll trace out the gameplay path with them. So of course, we also need a little bit more decoration. I think we're going to do this. I had a cool plan. So these blocks are pretty nice. We're just gonna do this. And I'm going to also chuck some 3D lines onto them, like so. And here's another tip we used to do back in the day. We used to just place a glow block. We'll place just a solid color block over the top of it, and it would color that. So that's pretty cool. Going to give that its own layer and place them around here a bit. So one there, one there, one there, one there, and one there. Neat. So that leads us onto spike design. We need some decoration down here. It's looking a bit bland. We're gonna go pretty simple with these things here. Like, let's just place a few of these around, make some of them green to add some of the contrasting colors, and some of them can be pink to blend in with the background. So we're almost done. We're almost complete here. I think we might also do this. We're going to copy and paste that there, and we're just going to cap it off like this, delete that, and now we've got this thing to place around. We're going to put that here. We're also going to place one maybe over here. Now, one last thing to do, we'll be placing these things, and these things are good. We'll place a few of them around in places that they, you know, can be placed. That made 100% sense. So last of all, we will be placing saw blades. We're going to be using these ones. I think we're actually going to go middle and small, and we'll design them. So why don't we go with a green hexagon to go there. Green hexagon in the middle of both of them. We will also add one of these things, very low opacity, and one of these things, same stuff, you know. We'll give them their own group and we'll place them around. And I'll just cut that part out because there's no point in showing you that, right? So would you look at that, we're done. We're all good, we've made our 1.9 level. Now it's time to play. We've got 700 objects. It took me about 20 minutes and I'm quite happy with it. I don't know actually if I'm happy with it because I haven't played it yet. So let's go ahead and play it and see what's up. Nice, I actually like that a lot. That it looks very nice. Well, not very nice, but it looks pretty cool. I'm happy for it. I'm quite happy that that's just all 1.9. Let's just play it again, because why not? Looks pretty fun. I mean, looks pretty cool. I'm happy. Honestly, I'm quite glad how that turned out. So I hope you guys enjoyed that video. That was quite a fun little video going back into 1.9 and trying to build in that style. I enjoyed it quite a lot, and you know, it reminded me of the golden age back in 1.9. I had a lot of fun creating back in that day. I just had a lot of fun in Geometry Dash, to be honest. I mean, of course, it's great having all this modern technology, all this cool stuff in 2.1, all these new features. I love that, but every now and then it's nice to go back and take a look, just like I did in the 1.0 level. So anyway, that will wrap up this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed. If you've noticed, I haven't been using the face cam because I've decided this new format for my videos. So the Let's Play videos and the playthrough videos where I'm playing levels will be with the face cam, and the building videos will not be with the face cam because, you know, the building videos are a little more technical. I don't really find the need for a face cam here. They cover up too much of the screen, and, you know, I think it's better just when I'm playing levels and so you can see the reaction and everything. But yeah, I'll be leaving out the face cam for building videos, and if you have a problem with that, just say in the comments, and if enough people want it back, of course I'll bring it back. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed that, guys. I'll see you on the next video. Until then, laters.